Hi, I'm Michael from SnapMarket. Today I'm going to show you how to take great HDR photos from your SLR camera. HDR stands for High Dynamic Range. Basically what it means is you may see an image and the shadows are too dark, the highlights are too bright. HDR basically, you can take three photos at different exposures, merge them all together, so your shadows, highlights and mid-tones become, you know, nice and flat, everything can be seen basically. You can do this on most cameras or most SLRs. Some point and shoots will also give you the feature. Basically the feature you need is exposure bracketing. You can also achieve the same effect with shutter speeds. You can go fast shutter speed and you'll get your low exposure, a slow one and you'll get your high exposure. So yeah, let's get to it. Okay, so here we are. Got my camera set up here. Today I'm using a Canon 60D. The features should be similar on most SLRs. If not, just, you know, you should be able to Google your camera and see how to change your settings or maybe just refer to your user manual. We're just going to take a picture of a plant today, nothing special. Okay, we'll start by turning our camera on and setting the mode to aperture priority. On most cameras this should be an A, this should just say AV. I'll try and get a shot of that. Okay. As for the drive, I have a 2 second timer, so that gives any tripod shake, it gives it the time to go away. So that way you get a nice, still, crisp shot. Okay, as for the settings, I'm just gonna leave my aperture on 4. ISO 100, this is very important. HDR images, they can create a lot of noise, so you wanna take the best quality shot possible. That's about all we need to set up there. So this is the Canon 60D. This is how you would set it up on this camera, and I'm sure pretty similar against most Canons. So you'd go to menu, second one across, you'll see there exposure composition, AEB, which is exposure bracketing. So you'll click on that, this is what you'll see. The wheel up here on this camera will extend the bracketing. So what we'll do, we'll go -2, 0, +2. So what this means is it's gonna take a photo as it normally would, which is 0, it's going to take a photo 2 stops down, so that'll be darker, and 2 stops up, which will be brighter. So we'll be taking 3 photos, darker, normal, brighter, and we'll be mixing these together, or blending these images together to get a nice flat image overall. So that's set up, just press set, okay, and my shot's already set up, so I can just go ahead and hit the shutter. And you could probably hear it, we just took 3 photos. And I'll show you those now. So we've got this one here, which is our normal exposure. This is what would have happened if I just hit the button without the exposure settings on. We've got this one here, which is the lower exposure. Obviously you can see it's pretty dark. Not sure if you can make that out on the camera, but. And we've got this one, which is really bright. So yeah, that's it. Now off to the computer. Okay, to merge our HDR images, we'll be using Photomatix Pro. There's plenty of other software out there you can use. Some's free, some isn't. The trial version of Photomatix is free, but I believe it leaves a watermark on your finished photo. Photoshop also has a built-in HDR merger, but Photomatix for me seem to produce the best results, so we'll be using this one. So basically just go up and click load bracketed photos. You can drag them in, so we'll just open our SD card here. Select them all, drag them in, press OK. Now pre-processing options we can play with here. Remove ghosts. This might be if, you know, your camera moved a bit. Something like that. I should have said before, but I highly recommend when taking HDR photos that you use a tripod. I've successfully taken plenty of them without a tripod, but if your light isn't good, then your shutter speed's open longer, you're gonna end up with blurriness and camera shake and ghosts. So we'll leave that off. Align source images, just tries to align the three images as best as possible, but if you used a tripod and you were very still, you should be fine. Reduce noise on source images. I like to keep that on because, as I said, HDR photos seem to create a lot of noise, so we'll leave that on and just press OK. And we'll load our source images up. Okay, so here we are. All three images emerged. That looks pretty awesome as it is. Photomatix comes with a lot of presets just down the side here, you can see. Right now it's on Painterly 3. So, I mean, you can play around with the presets and you might find something you like straight away. The other option is on the left side here, you've got all sorts of options, you know, tone compressor, detail enhancer. You can change the strength, color saturation, luminosity, contrast, lighting effects, pretty much everything you need to do. But for the sake of this, we'll just select one of these. Let's go with Painterly 2. It's not too overdone. And just click process. Okay, once you've hit process, you'll be at this screen here. You can do some finishing touches, add some highlights. Just bring the highlights up. As you can see, the highlights are getting brighter there. We'll leave them down. Lights, you know, how bright the image is overall, and how dark the darks are, and how present the shadows are, basically. We'll leave that as it is. You can hit done, then you can go to File, Save Image. Okay, it's saving the image now, so I'll show you the finished product in a moment. Okay, here is our finished image. Obviously, I could have played around with the settings a lot better. It looks a bit fake, but just for demonstration purposes, here's what I did. Here's the original. This would have been if I just hit the shutter straight off the camera. As you can see, it's quite bland, so it's everything looks flat. You know, the shadows are dark, the highlights are bright, but once blended together, it all kind of evens out. And yeah, I think in my opinion, it looks pretty good. As I said, I could have played around with the settings a little bit more and got something a bit more realistic looking, but overall, that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this tutorial very helpful. And if you ever take any awesome photos, make sure you come and sell them on snapmarket.com. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel, where we'll have a lot more tutorials and things like that in the future. Thanks again. Bye.